Mr. President, Excellencies, 75 years has passed since the founding of the United Nations. The world has changed dramatically. Crisis we have to cope with through multilateralism are expanding in diversity and scale. COVID-19 is a case in point. The crucial role of the UN to unite the international community have never been more necessary. We, the member states, cannot be complacent with the status quo. Rather, we need to take serious steps in close coordination with the UN organizations to reform the UN for the post-COVID era. Secretary General Guterres has been leading the effort to make the UN even more effective. Japan wants to see such reform make further headway this year. In this regard, the reform of the UN development system is critical to make sure that the most vulnerable will not be left behind. For a stronger UN, Security Council reform cannot wait any longer. I regret to say that today, the system designed 75 years ago do not fully deliver on the purpose of the Charter. I'm convinced that member states having the capacity and willingness to take on major responsibilities should hold seats on an expanded Security Council. Only then will the Council be revived as an effective and representative organ. Japan is fully prepared to fulfill such responsibilities as a permanent member of the Security Council and contribute to ensuring peace and stability of the world. In the declaration of this high-level meeting, we commit ourselves to instilling new life in the discussions on the Council reform. To fulfill that commitment and take a step forward, I call on all member states to launch text-based negotiations. Mr. President, this year also marks the 75th anniversary of the atomic bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. We have to keep in mind that the UN was founded to save succeeding generations from the scourge of war. Japan spares no effort to achieve this goal into the future. The future we want. Let us build it together. Thank you.